Welcome to the setup video for the AT-CAP-FC110, known as the Captivate 4K ePTZ auto framing camera. As a USB device, it's very easy to set up. Simply open the hinge bracket to mount the camera on top of a display. Connect the USB cable from the USB-C port on the camera to the USB port on your computer. Once the camera is connected, the LED indicator on the front will be blue for approximately 5 seconds. Then it will turn off. You should then see your computer has finished setting up the camera. When the camera is streaming, the LED will remain on. Now, to set up the camera, you'll need the remote control. Turn the camera on in the camera app or your unified communication platform, such as Zoom or Microsoft Teams. Under the setup for the devices for the program, you can check the video for your space. You will want the camera to be on for the on-screen display menu. Use the three lines in the upper right corner of the remote control to see the on-screen display menu. You'll see all of the submenus: image, color tone, system, device info, and defaults. Use the arrows on the remote to move through the submenus. Select the middle home button to open the submenu. The image submenu is used to adjust the image, and you'll want to check that the auto frame feature is on. Use the arrow to the right to turn the auto frame feature on or off, but we're going to make certain it's set to on. The other settings under the image are pretty standard for most camera settings, including brightness, contrast, hue, saturation, sharpness, and gain to increase or decrease the output signal from the camera's sensor. Some other settings that are very helpful include anti-flicker, which allows you to change the setting if the light in the room is exhibiting a flickering effect. Flickering is caused when the frame rate does not match the frequency of the display or the light bulbs. The default setting is 60 Hz, which is the common setting for most incandescent and fluorescent bulbs in North America. However, the UK, Australia, and elsewhere typically operate at 50 Hz. To eliminate any flickering, set the frequency to the same operating frequency for the region. The other setting is the backlight compensation or BLC feature, which automatically adjusts the exposure control for the camera. When enabled, BLC will attempt to increase the ambient foreground light and darken any background light. The next submenu is the color tone, which has a single option, white balance. White balance can be set to auto, manual, and static. White balance is the process of removing unnatural color casts from an image so that the objects which are white appear as white in the image. White balance is set to auto by default. When it's set to manual, you are able to adjust the red or the blue. First, select the object that's supposed to be white, and then use the sliders until the object appears correct. You can also choose to set static settings. This will allow you to adjust the color temperature in kelvins. The default is 4500, and you can adjust the color temperature up or down. The next submenu is the system. Here you can adjust the language between English or Chinese. You can also adjust the IR address. This will need to be changed if there's more than one camera in the environment. If there are multiple remotes, they must be a unique IR address, either 1, 2, or 3. Once set, you will need to set the IR on the remote, or else it won't receive any more commands. Press and hold the F1 key for 5 seconds until the LED indicator is a solid red. Then select the corresponding IR address. The LED will blink once and then turn off. The channel should be successfully changed. The next setting is the mirror. This option will mirror the image vertically, reversing the image. This is useful if you're doing anything with writing. The flip setting will flip the image horizontally, producing an upside down image. This option is useful to correct images for cameras that are mounted upside down or on a ceiling mount. The zoom limit sets the maximum zoom limit. Available values are 2x, 3x, and 4x, and the default is 3x. Expert mode, when enabled, will display a tracking frame on the screen. This is usually used to analyze tracking problems in particular scenarios. There are two sensitivity settings. Detection sensitivity sets the motion detection for the camera. The values are high, middle, or low. The default is high, but if the camera is behaving erratically when tracking multiple subjects, then you may want to turn it down. The other is framing move sensitivity. This determines how much movement is required to cause the camera to reframe. The higher the number, the smaller the movement that is required to cause a reframe. The settings available are 0 to 8, and the default is set to 5. The last two items on this submenu are target lost action. This is what the camera will do when smart framing target is lost. Its available values are stay or preset 1. When it's set to stay, the camera will remain in its current position. When set to preset 1, the camera will automatically move to that saved preset. In order to set up the three presets, set up the image in the way you would like it to be. Then press and hold the number button for 3 seconds. This will set the preset. To recall it, simply press the button. The audio delay is the last setting in this section. In some cases, the video and audio may not be in sync. There may be reasons this might happen. So we've made it available for the ability for you to delay the audio in milliseconds. Our default is 0. The device information will give us the IR address that was previously set and the current firmware version. These cannot be modified. Finally, you can reset all of the settings in the camera to default. If you accidentally select it and you want to abort, simply select the menu button. Or you can continue to reset the camera by selecting the home button. This will reset the camera to factory default. Well, that's all there is to set up the ATCAP-FC110 4K ePTZ auto-framing camera. For more information, go to www.atlona.com/product/AT-CAP-FC110.